All right. Well, hello again, YouTube. Right now I find myself in the quaint little town of Amberley. There is a sign just there that says the Inland Senic Route is just ahead. So let's go. Very much a little farming community town here. And there we go. Inland Senic Route. State Highway 72. Here's the start of it. A couple of interesting places in this town because it is quite a busy town. Alright. 72 this way. It really is quite a big town in comparison to some of the ones we'll be going through today. Got a lot of history. We started out there at Chamberlain Park, a little bit of a memorial to yesteryear with a cob cottage. Literally it's made of this material they call cob. Very, very hardy, very warm. That's how the settlers of New Zealand built the first houses. Well, at least in Canterbury. But we're going to have a bit of open road from here through to Sefton and then all the way around to Rangiora and then heading for the Oxford Bridge area through the Wabak Bridge, the Kaya Bridge. So it's going to be a lot of the one-lane bridges that we've seen before in this channel, but this is it. This is the start of Inland Senic Route. Very, very beautiful route. Basically runs straight inland and then along the hills. So you may have seen the Southern Alps in movies like the Lord of the Rings series. This route will literally be taking us right down the side of them. Once we get to them, all the way through to Geraldine and then up into the middle of them. Once I get to Geraldine, I'll be heading across the hills into the actual hills themselves for Feeling, which is today's destination. It's just after 4:30, unfortunately. So it's going to be probably closer to 8. So with 23k's from here to Rangiora. It's going to be closer to 8, as I said. 8 o'clock probably by the time I get to Feely. I might stop at Geraldine for tea. As this is a long, long ride. Now, with any luck, I'll be able to do this in one video. So I'm probably not going to be able to talk much during the ride, as this is probably too much wind noise as it is right now. I'm literally just about shouting, hoping that this will come through. Cross fingers. Now I am wearing a couple of layers underneath my summer jacket, so I've also got a hoodie to throw on in the back in case it gets rather cool further down. As I suspect by the time we get to Geraldine we'll be possibly in the shadow of the hills. Okay, that fuel gauge on this bike has this little twitch that does, but it drops from half down to empty and it means you really are running on the bottom of the tank and the needle will just sit there ticking. So thankfully I'm not far from the bridge, as this looks like part of the low burn, and that bridge gets us into Rangiora, and we'll grab some gas in Rangiora. Cutting it a bit fine, I think, but but I didn't fill the tank in the last video, and we've done quite a few k's since that. Oh no, so we're in Ashley. But the bridge is not that far away from here, thankfully. And at the bridge there is, well, just before we get to the bridge, we're going to get to the road, which is T intersection. We turn to our left and we get into town, into Rangiora. But if we were to go right, it would be a really beautiful ride all the way around Lowburn and out to Oxford Parkway. Definitely worth the tour if you've got time in Christchurch. But no point going that way today. Especially since I actually don't know within your special station that way is. As it is, we're just going to go over the Ashley River here. Across our braided rivers, which New Zealand is one of the only countries with braided rivers like that. Right. Petrol station. Alrighty. We are all gassed up. Going to do a little bit of a full rotation and back out of town. Our next major little town, if you will, would be Oxford, and then we hit the gorges. Alrighty, so here we are, Oxford. Literally at the foot of the Southern Alps. Over the, behind, straight ahead. If I could see over those trees, you'd be able to see where the outer pathway goes up. And basically through a gap almost in the hills. But here we are. Cruising down the main street of Oxford. Oh. Yep, this is not a good look. Bridge needs to be resealed, but they haven't done it. But this is the patch coming up where they were working last time we were through here. And there are cones again. How has it taken them 3 months? Sealed. At least it's sealed. I guess they're doing a lot of Armco's still. State Highway 73 for literally not long at all. this will do. I have to clean the screen and you guys off. Alrighty, you're clean, I'm clean. And right, we're good to go. Thirsty. But good to know there is a dairy here across the road from a school. This is Glen Tunnel after all. It is another one of those little farming communities. That is one I will have to do at some stage. Here's another one lane bridge over a little creek. Okay, return that way, good to know, thank you. Here we are dropping down into the Rakaia Gorge.
you won't let me.
Right. Cleaned up, I can see out. Got gas. And with any luck, there's a little takeaway bar up here and it's still open. If not, I guess I'll just grab takeaways and Veely. Music back up and running. And on the road. Full tank of gas. Only got sort of 40 odd k's to do. There it is, the valley that Veely sits in. Just come around a couple of corners and I'll go past that industrial area there and we're across the bridge and into town. Now this last part, Geraldine to Veely, is not technically part of the Inland Senic Route. The Inland Senic Route technically goes from Geraldine out to Temuka to Timaru. But this is the Geraldine Veely Highway. I have made my destination at about 8:15 approximately, which isn't too bad. Opahi River. Right. There we go, Mount Cook Highway, State Highway 8. Alright, time to find a takeaway shop. Alright. Looks like I found one next to the Veely Bakehouse. So we'll call this done.